Okay, so basically the topic is I have chosen for this talk is artificial intelligence based tools for literature search and review. And these days we are seeing a lot of applications of AI in our daily life. Like in the last November, the OpenAI launched the Chat GPT. And before that, last some 4 or 5 years, there was a very much hype on AI, and people were trying to apply mostly the text-based, like natural language-based products in the daily life of the humans. But earlier that, the AI field itself is more than 50 years old, and a lot of people have attempted, and it's a long journey how AI has come to this stage, what we are seeing today. But now I think the participants here in this conference and normal people also these days, they recognize this term, what is AI? Because it has impacted every person in the society. So it is in academic research also, this AI has got some applications, which I am going to share some of the tools that are being launched every day. And we see that in the research field also, like the research management, reference management, research writing, discovery, monitoring, a lot of applications are being released every day. And these applications are really helpful for researchers, especially the people in the developing countries, to use these AI tools for enhancing their productivity and other benefits I'll share later on. So what is an AI? Just a small intro, like it is basically the replication of human intelligence process by machines, particularly computer systems. And it's a branch of computer science that researches and creates intelligent machines. And it refers to a computer or a robot controlled by a computer's capacity to do jobs that are normally performed by humans because they require human intellect and discernment. So this is the main the important benefit of AI, that the machines can do what earlier humans were able to do. Although most of us will agree that the machines cannot do everything, but to some extent these days we are seeing a lot of applications where machines are now replacing humans in several parts, and this has caused havoc also. Like we are seeing a lot of jobs are like the jobs are cutting down because of these systems are available. So some of the applications that are available, we can see that availability of expert systems, chatbots like ChatGPT we are seeing these days, it is very popular. Natural language processing tools, like earlier in natural language, we used to write a lot of programs and coding to do a simple task. Now it is very easily available with the help of the available tools. Speech recognition is getting smarter every day. We have speech assistants, AI assistants in our homes like Alexa and Google, Amazon, this one, and then computer and the traffic management and other aspects, we are seeing a lot of applications of AI. So coming to the research where the AI applications can be helpful, if we see the research workflow, we follow these steps usually in the research workflow, like discovery. Then means we discover the data, we discover the literature, we analyze it, then we write the research, then we try to get it published somewhere or publish in the form of dissertation. Then we disseminate it, means we try to make it reach the people for audience to for whom we have written this research. And these days we see a lot of assessment activities also, because the researchers are also assessed and your research output is also assessed. So these are the broad topics, broad steps that we follow. And AI, we search for literature, where we try to find out the literature, discover, or we try to find the data, secondary data, from where we can get the secondary data. And in the writing part also, a lot of AI applications are being made in all the areas, like outreach, assessment. Also, AI applications are being used and are being developed every day. So, in this slide, just I have mentioned that what is discovery step? It involves discovery of existing knowledge, updates about new research, getting ideas, capturing literature of interest, finding sources of data, and others. what tools you must have if you are trying to, if you are a researcher, you should have your own device, at least preferably a desktop with good internet speed connectivity. That is very much required these days. And the web browser, Google Chrome or Firefox, which is very essential, PDF reader with annotation facility, that will be really helpful. And also we need these days as researcher, we also need some cloud storage space also, because there are chances of losing data if we have only stored our data, research data in the form of a storage in the local laptop or desktop only. So we need a cloud storage also these days. So we have to equip ourselves with the modern tools to conduct research. Similarly, for monitoring literature, means what are the different new literature that is coming up? We have to create alerts on scholarly databases such as Google Scholar. We can have keyword-based alerts on Google Scholar. We can follow scholars also of interest. Scopus database also has this alerts feature we can follow. Microsoft Academic, although this database is now not existence, it is just last year Microsoft Academic was dropped by Microsoft. Dimensions, another database we can use, Web of Science. We all are very much aware that Web of Science and Scopus and Google Scholar, but these Web Dimensions is also a good database, which is basically some claims to be AI based, we can also capture feeds of our preferred journals using feed reader software. Follow experts on social medias, Twitter. Twitter has a good, like now these days it is called X. It has a good like a good community of people, experts. So means as a researcher, we should follow some of the experts in our field so that we get to know what kind of research they are contributing, what kind of activities they are doing. So it is a good practice to follow experts in the on the social media. ResearchGate is another platform which is very essential these days, that we should make our profile there, upload papers so that people read them. We get more citations, because ultimately our research has to reach, we have to disseminate it so that it reaches the person who is intended to going to use it, so that we will have some impact of our work in the form of citations. Academia.edu is another academic social networking site that we can follow. Mendeley groups are another good way where we can, similar people can come together. We can share documents with each other. Reference management software we can use, like Mendeley or Zotero, to organize, read, and review the articles that are of interest to us. So, what are the benefits of using literature review or AI-based tools? Improves efficiency, it reduces a lot of time that we have to spend on reviewing literature. So these just I will show you some of the tools also if I have time. If we can get some complete information, remove any prejudices if there are, we can using AI tools we can remove prejudices also. We can find research gaps in a very simple way using AI tools. We can take help of AI tools to develop research questions. If some idea is there, we can form some brainstorming can be done with the help of AI tools, and we can reach to definite research questions. We can like I'll show you some tools where we can organize and structure the literature also. And these tools also support several languages these days. So these are some of the tools that I will discuss that are helpful for researchers. And usually these tools are for literature search and literature review. And these two, the last two tools, AS Review and Ryan, these tools are basically for systematic literature review, like for the people who are in medicine domain, health information or health domain. They are specifically more targeted to systematic literature review, so much help. Of Sciespace is basically a kind of an assistance. And it has a bunch of tools that are available. So it is a database of over 270 million documents, and it is very easy to locate academic publications using Sciespace. And it is an upcoming database, recently launched, and a lot of research papers are available. They have a Chrome extension also you can install in your machine, and it helps in summarizing the papers also using Copilot. That one feature is there. If you are reading a paper, say in your browser, and if you have installed this Chrome extension, you can click on this Copilot. One icon will be there available in the side left hand right hand side. If you click on it, you can ask some questions of the out of that paper. For example, what is the methodology that is the particular paper researcher has used? Or if you want to summarize that paper, you can take help of this tool, and the tool will summarize the paper or bring out some highlights in some 4 or 5 points. So you can use those points for writing literature review. So, like rather than spending the whole reading the papers, time in reading the whole paper, you can take help of this tool to get some highlights, or you can ask some, you can have some ask some questions and get some answers out of the paper also. So the best thing with this tool is that you can ask a follow-up question also. For example, if you have asked that what kind of methodology the paper has followed, then the tool will respond to you something. Then you can further ask questions. So that is the one of the coolest features of the Sciespace tool, which you can directly chat with the particular PDF you are reading. You can ask questions out of that. So that is very helpful. Similarly, you can ask questions like, what are the future works in this paper? So that directly you can find some ideas and you can work upon later. So Copilot is the good feature. You can install this tool in your browser, and it is very helpful. In the end, I will show you the websites of these tools also. Another tool that I have picked is that is iris.ai. Iris is basically this is a workspace tool where you can bookmark a lot of papers, and also you can create some maps out of the papers, interactive maps. So that I will also show you, and it will the map will be created, and the maps will be organized automatically by the system in some topics. So and it is very easy to browse, and it has a paper finder also. If you put a paper, and if you have, say, for example, if you have a seed paper with you, seed paper means one paper which is very interesting for you, or which is very close to the research you want to conduct, then you can use that paper as a seed paper in this, and then give that paper to this tool, and it will find out the similar paper from the pool of papers it has and bring it in front of you. So, like, you can discover those studies which you were not able to discover among the pile of papers when you conduct search on Scopus or Web of Science. So here you do not have to worry, like reading each and every paper. The similar papers will be automatically taken out by this tool and bring in front for you so that you can further explore. Another tool that I have picked up is Elicit. Elicit is basically a good tool, very good tool, and it's one of the popular tools these days, and its development is very fast these days. Every week I get mail that they have added some new features. So this is basically the full form is Evidence Library for Information Capture and Integration Tools, and it is abbreviated as Elicit, web-based application that aids researcher in collecting, organizing, synthesizing, and reporting literature-based evidence. So the cool thing with this feature is that you can ask direct questions. For example, previous speaker was talking about doping something with in some other metal to increase the magnetism, or say hydrophobic properties on the surface, something like that. So you can directly ask question to this tool, and it on the basis of the literature available in this database. Basically, they are using in the background, they are using another database that is Scholar database. So using that database, they will give you authentic information from the papers, extracting from the papers, and they will form it will form a, an answer for you. I'll show you a demo of this also. And you can select any paper to view a summary, its key point, pertinent information, related papers, what are the methodology that paper has used, what is the sample size that paper has used, what kind of population that paper has selected. So all these minute informations are automatically extracted from the paper and presented to the researcher. So it is very easy for you to write a review or to find out the important topics or themes out of a bunch of papers. Another is that is called Research Rabbit. Research Rabbit is also an AI-powered app that helps researchers find, organize, and analyze research papers. In Research Rabbit, also you start with a seed paper. A seed paper means, or if you have some papers already with you, or your supervisor has given some papers to read, and then you can put those papers on Research Rabbit, and then it will give you a bunch of papers that are related to that papers. So it means a kind of it's a kind of a an AI-based assistant that is giving you similar papers which you might have missed while searching on Scopus. So among 3,000 results, it will be very difficult to find out which are the papers are that are similar to your paper. So keyword-based searching will not work here. So basically, these tools are based on the cited literature. What literature the one paper has cited based on the similarity of the references, the tool suggests the articles that might be of interest to you. Now, these two tools I will discuss, that is AS Review and Rayaan. These AS Review is basically open source machine learning tools. And basically, this tool is used for systematic review. So in systematic review, what we do, we take a particular area, and then on the basis of on that area, whatever research is published, we extract that research, and then by following some inclusion and exclusion criteria, we remove the papers which are not relevant, and we include the papers which are of relevant to that particular topic or the problem that we have chosen. Now, the problem is that this takes a lot of time. Like if you have done some systematic review, you might be aware that it will take more than 1 year to conduct a proper systematic review. With this tool, this time can be limited. You can reduce that time. So what it does that it's a free tool. You collect the literature using some Scopus or some other database, and then you give the list of references to this tool, and then automatically what it does that based on it will ask you questions whether the one for example you start with the top and the first article if it is of relevance to you or not. You will say yes. Then automatically from the pile of the papers that are behind below this paper which you have reviewed, if they are of relevance based on your answer, the tool will automatically exclude the other papers that are piled up in the line. So this helps you to reduce the number of papers that need to be reviewed. So what will happen that you will always get a relevant paper in the queue, and the irrelevant paper will be shifted down in the queue. So once you start getting a lot of irrelevant papers, automatically you can stop there. There are chances that you will not get more relevant papers below that. So this is a good tool if you are going to perform meta-analysis or systematic review, you can use this tool. Similarly, another tool is Rayaan, rayaan.ai, and this is also used a tool that is used for faster systematic reviews. It is also AI-powered, and it will help to quickly go through the number of papers like deduplication, screening the papers, organizing references. You can collaborate. Multiple people can collaborate and do this screening part. So in systematic reviews, if you have done, then you might be aware that it takes a lot of time in doing these tasks rather than reading the literature individually. So reading part is very less. For example, if we collect some 4,000 or 5,000 articles, ultimately we will be having some 100 or 150 articles that will be included in systematic review, which means that we have to read all the 4,000 articles to reach 150 articles. So with the help of these tools, we can reduce the time which we have to spend to screen out the irrelevant ones. So some of the things that we have to keep in mind when using literature review based AI tools, one is that is called quality control. So finding regularly, but they are yet flawed, means these tools are available. We cannot say that these tools are 100% perfect. So always you have to see whether whatever the suggestions that paper is giving or the answer that the illicit like tools are giving, whether they are relevant or not, whether they are correct or not. There are some ethical considerations also, like we are talking about these days, that these AI tools should be whether accepted or not. A debate is going on whether AI, like ChatGPT generated content, should be included in research papers or not, whether ChatGPT can be included as a co-author for a research paper or not. So these are some of the points that should be considered, whether it is ethical. So always, like as academicians, we are aware what is ethically correct. So that thing we have to keep in mind. Stay updated. AI is always changing, so keep with literature review, AI tools to maximize your study. Over reliance, don't over rely on these tools. These are just for assistant. Don't take it granted. Data privacy is one of the concern, but before using the tools, always check their how they are going to use your data. Authority and responsibility. Find out. Don't just follow any tool. Just first read who are the authority behind that particular tool. What kind of people have made that tool, whether they are reliable or not, or what kind of people have already, companies are already procured that tool. On the basis of this, you can decide whether you can use that tool or not. So with this, I conclude. If we have little bit time, I can show the this one also. I have just this is the interface of Iris. So just I have a search for understanding the diversity of membrane lipid composition, and I can see that this has divided into like lipid, cholesterol, booklet, composition, membrane. I can select any tool and I can find out the papers related to each tool. I can explore, I can see what are the growth, 16 papers on cellular eukaryotic, something like that. This is ELICIT. Like the previous speaker was talking about something like doping of cobalt, something whether it increases property. At that time, I just wrote this question to elicit whether doping of cobalt increases magnetic property. So it gave me an answer that the paper collectively suggests that doping of cobalt can affect the magnetic properties of certain materials. And it gives the citation also, like doping with Fe slightly increases magnetization in cobaltites. So you see, such kind of tools are available. You can it has, on the basis of four papers, it has created a summary for you. And then you can go down and see all the papers that are available in that area. So ELICIT is very good. You and the it provides a lot of columns, like you can see like study design, what was the study design, what was the duration, what was the dose, participant count, participant age, population, sex, region, limitations, funding source, and a lot of other things also you can even add here. So if you want, you can add, like for example, if I say I need a summary also, then it will create a column summary. And here it will add the summary for each paper. You see, I am getting the summary. So I don't have to download the paper and read it. Okay, by going through the summary, if it is of interest, I can go to this paper and download it. I can bookmark it. I can add it to this one, my library, and then I can upgrade and download to as a BibTeX or other things also. So this is ELICIT Research Rabbit. You see, I have created one collection by using something like we were doing on tuberculosis, and in this I have added one paper, and it is suggesting me 57 papers which are similar to this paper, and these are the five authors. Then if I want, I can see the all 57 papers one by one, and I can see their network also. I can see in the basis of timeline also. Like if I am interested in only 2020 to 20 papers, that also I can. So this is another very good paper. AS review I have already shown. Then we can download this and perform the yes no, like whether the this particular yes or no, the particular article is of interest, yes or no. Then on the basis of that, it suggests the other papers are relevant or not. Similarly, Ryan AI. I can create a review, and on the basis of which I can say whether yes or no on that particular article, and I can perform the systematic review, means I can screen out the articles.